everybody's watching her, but she's looking at you.
Grampi, I'm Grampi.
I'm
here. And if you hear any noise in the background, it's because our grandkids are actually upstairs and they're making noise. So if you hear anything, it's them. So like I said, we like to travel, and I wanted to talk to you all. We wanted to start giving like tips and so forth. So if these get popular, we'll start to do more. But we've gone on a few cruises, I think four or five.
That sounds about right.
Four. And so we wanted to start giving little tips because unlike a lot of the other people who give tips, we're of a certain age. And so
and we're not as old as we as we may feel. we're not as old as we may portray, but I guess that's the humor of it, because in our adventures we've realized that we weren't as young and spunky as we used to be. So hopefully these tips will help help our fellow middle-aged cruisers, and will also benefit some of our seniors. So find the humor in this with us, please, and just enjoy.
Definitely. So one of the first things we wanted to talk about was getting to the ship. Now, we went on a cruise, and some of the videos are already posted. We went on a cruise in September, and this was our venture back to Norwegian. We really like Norwegian. We tried Carnival a year ago.
It was okay.
Yeah, it was just okay. But prior to, we had gone out on Norwegian a few times, and we really liked the aspect of the freestyle dining and so forth. And so to go from freestyle to something a little more rigid, where we had a set place to eat, a set table, and a set like people who we sat with, even though we sat with a wonderful couple.
Yes.
And but so the rigidity of Carnival was like something I didn't
rigidness.
Like. Rigidity.
Rigidness.
It's rigid. and so I didn't like that. But you know, the Carnival cruise was very inexpensive. So for the money, there were a lot of things we put up with. And we'll talk another time about shore excursions and such. But so this last cruise, we flew out early in the morning, left home at like 3 o'clock in the morning, and arrived at the airport in good time, parked the car in good time. We checked in, got through TSA, everything perfect without a hitch. And plane left on time. Mm-hmm. And we had a layover in, what was it, Detroit, I think? Something like that.
Yeah.
Got out of Detroit fine. We were flying into Fort Lauderdale. And everything was good until about maybe 20 minutes before we were to land. And the plane just kind of deviated because there was electrical storms in...
Big rainstorm, big thunderstorm.
Fort Lauderdale.
Mm-hmm.
And so we were watching on the little monitor how the plane went way out, back, started going north, and then it went and flew over the Bahamas and came back. And so we spent another hour in the air easily. And so the pilot let us know that they were going to try and land.
Mm-hmm.
And so they slowly made their way. We landed. Once we landed in Fort Lauderdale, we actually sat on the runway for another 45 minutes or so. That's because the terminal shut down and they wouldn't open the gates. So eventually we did. Now, I do want to point out, we booked ground transportation. And so once we got to the baggage claim where we're supposed to check in and get, you know, ground transportation, catch the bus and so forth, the person had already left. Mm-hmm. What was his name? I think they said his name.
Jack.
Like Jack left.
Mm. Just left.
Yes.
Even though our flight was announced coming in late and we had just gotten down to the baggage section, Jack left us. And just know that when you book for ground transportation, that the cruise line takes no responsibility for the contracted services that you seek out independently of the cruise. So unfortunately, it was a loss for us, but the cruise line was more than kind to help us out later, much later.
But that's where the adventure began.
It sure did.
So we got our luggage immediately and rushed out and just grabbed the first cab that we could see. Mm-hmm. And we jumped in the cab, and the cab driver said that it was only,
I think he said, 35 minutes
or so,
no traffic,
to get to the Port of Miami. So now, mm-hmm. let's see, it's now just after 2 o'clock, and Norwegian asked that you're on the ship at least 2 hours before departure. Departure was at 4. Mm-hmm. So now we're within that 2 hour window. So we're riding, we're doing real well, and we can see the Port of Miami. And we get off in downtown Miami. Now, we're familiar with Miami because we frequent Miami, or had, mm-hmm. before we discovered cruising. And so we knew where we were, and we knew that there was still a little ways to the port. So we're seeing Bayside and mm-hmm. all of these things. And now, all of a sudden, the cab driver looked like he didn't know where he was going. Mm-hmm.
I think his gig was, knowing that we were up against a timeline, I kind of figured out after. I think he was working up his tip I'll be nice. I think he was hoping that we would say, we'll give you
$50. Just get us there. And so prior to this, I always said, as far as reality TV is concerned, I couldn't do Survivor. I couldn't do most of the other. The only
Big Brother.
I couldn't do Big Brother for sure. but the only reality TV show I ever thought maybe I could do, we could
was
do,
the was Amazing Race.
And so now I take it all back, because after that cab ride, I realized we would not do well.
And the closer we got to the port, everything seemed to go in slow motion. The driver slowed down, the lights slowed down, traffic slowed down.
And stoplights were taking forever.
Sat through a couple stoplights because the driver wasn't paying attention. And we were in the back seat getting more and more anxious, nearly sweating, trying to get to this port. So I think we were down to, what, the last four, terminals to the boats.
Yeah, so we got to the Port of Miami, and there was a Carnival ship docked, mm-hmm. and then a little further.
And we almost ended up on Carnival. We had to tell the driver, no, keep going.
So we're like, you know, we're telling him Terminal B.
D?
And he's like, nope. And we're like, B, as in boy.
C?
And now we're yelling, we're like, go.
Just go.
Go, please go. And so we made it, and we were able to get on the ship, and everything was wonderful after that. We didn't give them any extra tip.
We gave them a tip, of course.
We didn't give them any extra. But ultimately, what we're talking about, or what our tip today or now is,
consider arriving a day early.
Yes. And so from now on, Mimi and Grampy, when we travel, we will try to get there a day early, mm-hmm. because it just allows you to ease into your vacation. Mm-hmm. You don't want to go into vacation with, you know, that kind of anxiety, because the truth is, they will leave you.
They sure will.
And, you know,
you met another party that had arrived just like 2 minutes before. Like,
yeah, it was literally the ship left at 4:00. They got there to the port. They got there at like 4:15. Mm-hmm. And they had experienced the same thing. It was a group of 10 people. They were rerouted. They were supposed to land in Fort Lauderdale. They got rerouted to Orlando, mm-hmm. or something to that
effect.
And I
think by the time we got to our room, I think we had, an hour to spare?
Yes.
But, you know, because our luggage was not, you know, brought onto the ship as timely, and because we were still getting all the information that we needed when we checked in, our luggage didn't arrive to our room for quite a while. In fact, we started scouting the hallways as they were, you know, bringing them to the floors, at least. We started scouting the hallways because we just needed to relax and refresh and shower and then go get something to eat. It was exhausting. It was stressful. But when we got in the room, I think we both kind of just sat in quiet and stillness for a little bit just to decompress.
And you'll see the other video if you look for the yes. Finally We Made It video. You can kind of see... you know, we were a little beat up, and I was real beat up because I couldn't hear from the flight. But and that took a couple days to actually regain my hearing. But from now on, for us, even some upcoming cruises, we are going to most certainly arrive a day early, get a room, and make sure that we can just go right to the port first thing in the morning. And that'll alleviate all of the stress that could be associated with travel. But I honestly didn't think it would be a problem us leaving that day. And
we had
and
it. So we forth. Had the schedule down pat precisely to the hour. And thank God we made it and still yes. enjoyed a wonderful trip. But
wonderful.
That's our tip for the day. And hopefully your arrival to your cruise will go without a hitch.
Yes.
And and you'll ease right on to plenty of enjoyment.
All right. Well, thank you for watching Grampy and Mimi. I'm Grampy.
And I'm Mimi.
All right. You have a blessed day.